Day one here in Guangzhou. There you get a beautiful shot of last night's opening ceremony at the main Universiade Stadium. On today's program, we'll take a look at men's gymnastics competition as it gets underway. Floor, rings, and pommel horse. Then we'll move to the pitch. A couple great football matches featuring Russia and Mexico, as well as Brazil and Poland. Women's 1 meter springboard diving competition. The Chinese dominated in Kazan. Can they do the same thing here in Guangzhou? And basketball competition underway. United States of America taking on Turkey. Artistic gymnastics competition underway here at the Guangzhou Women's University, here at the 28th Summer University Games. First up, this is Akash Modi of the United States on the pommel horse. Modi, a mechanical engineering student from Stanford University. He was a 2015 NCAA team all-around parallel bars and high bar silver medalist, as well as a pommel horse bronze medalist this year in the U.S. national competition. And showing that incredible speed and pace here to go along with the balance and strength that makes up the pommel horse. And a very nice dismount there for Modi. And you can see he's quite pleased with that performance. Now you get a close-up look at the hands and just the quickness that these athletes have to have on the pommel horse. Get a good look here at his dismount. Executes that perfectly. And he will score 14.450. He's the lead pommel horse standings in men's qualifications. Now it's Modi on floor. He finished fifth in floor, the 2015 World Challenge Cup event in Sao Paulo, Brazil. A little bit of a hop there on that pass. As mentioned, was a silver medalist in the all-around NCAA championships back in the United States. Scoops that very well. Another pass here for Modi. There. He'll finish up, and again, very pleased with this performance. Smile on his face tells you that. You see that little bit of a hop on his previous pass. Executes the others very well. Step out there as well, but at 14.700, he also leads the floor exercise in men's qualification. We'll now move over to the rings. This is Ibrahim Kolak of Turkey. He attends the Ege University in Izmir. Of course, Izmir was the host of the 2005 World University Games. Polak won bronze in rings a few weeks back at the European Games in Baku, Azerbaijan. Unbelievable strength of these athletes on the rings. It's so evident, and you see that there again as he will try to get himself just parallel. And the strain on their arms is quite incredible, and yet they show such poise and patience. Polak demonstrating that here. There's dismount, very well done by Kolak. He's a little bit unhappy, just a slight step. But all in all, a very solid performance. He will score 15.400. And that will put him second in qualification behind Armenian Artur Tovmasyan, who scored a 15.750. Now you see that dismount, just a slight hop there. But all in all, a good performance for Ibrahim Kolak of Turkey. There you see the results in men's rings qualification. Now time for women's diving from the Nambu University Aquatic Center. This is the 1 meter springboard competition, the final. Here is Sun Meng Chen of China. Very nice dive for her. So see a good replay of it here. She will finish overall with a score of 272.85. And she will take the bronze medal. Now Kim Nam-hee of South Korea. She won a bronze at the 2014 Asian Games in the 1 meter springboard. Very nice dive for her too. This will be enough to put her in silver medal position with a score of 274.95.
6.5, 7. Total score, 50.7.
Now this is a Zheng Shuangzhui of China. She won 3 gold medals at the 2013 Universiade in Kazan in the 3 meter springboard, the 3 meter springboard synchro, and in team. But here in the 1 meter springboard, she's looking to do the same and capture gold.
Seven and a half.
That will be enough to do it for her. You'll get a good replay of it here.
Seven and a half. Total score.
Her total score, 286.20. She will win the gold medal in the women's 1 meter springboard competition. There you see the final medal standings in women's 1 meter springboard. And now the women's football action from the Naju Public Stadium here in Gwangju. First up, Group C action, Brazil and Poland. It's a nice through ball there by Brazil. It'll end up on the foot of De Jesus Camargo Derico, and Brazil comes up to a 1-0 lead. Now we move into the 75th minute. There's a nice little chip in there for a goal by Diane Moretti. And that puts Brazil up 2-0. Now a corner for Brazil. High header eludes the keeper. And that one is in. 3-0 Brazil. Paulino Cardoso with the goal. And that's your final. Brazil over Poland, 3-0. There you see the standings in Group C. Now to the Honam University football field. It is Mexico taking on Russia. First up here, and there's a great header in. That is Kozhnikova of Russia, member of their national team. She scores, and Russia is up 1-0 just before halftime. Now in the 55th minute, there's a great strike off the boot of Anna Kolyovagya, and Russia now up 2-0. Now late in the match, 84th minute, to Budovic with a great through ball there, and Tarakova will finish it off in fine fashion. Another member of the Russian national team, and she makes it 3-0 for Russia. Now Mexico late in the match looking to get on the board. Great little chip there, but that one is stopped. And Russia in Group B action defeats Mexico 3-0. And there you see the standings in Group B. Men's basketball action. Dongkang College Gymnasium, the site of this matchup between Turkey and the United States. Turkey up 15-7 early. There's a nice three-pointer knocked down by Senli. Turkey looking to build on its lead. That one falls a bit short. Rebounded by the U.S. Ball moved ahead. And a nice strong finish there on the rebound. That's Hunter Mickelson for the U.S. You'll notice the U.S. wearing Kansas jerseys. This is the Kansas University Jayhawks team playing and representing the United States. Wayne Selden knocks that one down. The U.S. now up 42-38. Now late in the third quarter, great alley-oop there. Selden on the receiving end of that pass. That brings the American fans to their feet. There you see a great shot of it. Selden, no mistake there. Now midway through the fourth quarter. Rebound for Turkey, down by six. And there's a great finish. That's number six, Yigit Vardal, trying to get Turkey back in it. Under a minute to go, the U.S. up by six. And that should ice it. Frank Mason with the take right to the rim. U.S. up eight. Turkey, though, not going away. But that one is blocked on the attempt there by Begul. And there you'll see Begul goes right to the rim, and a nice block there by Jamari Traylor. And that'll do it. 66-57, the Americans in their opening matchup defeat Turkey. As Group D action is underway in Gwangju.
Everybody making moves, making moves.